Lesson 1, Relations and Functions. What is a relation? Relation is a, every subset of A cross B is a relation from A to B. That is relation. Domain and range of a relation. The set of all first elements in an ordered pairs is called the domain of the relation, and set of second elements is called the range of a relation. Next question. If R equal to ordered pair A comma A cube, A is a prime number, less than 5. Find its range. We know that range is the second element, therefore A cube. Here what is A? Prime number less than 5, that is 2, 3. It is domain. Range 2 cube, 3 cube, that is 8, 27. Range of a relation is 8, 27. Next question. R equal to ordered pair x comma y such that x plus 2y equal to 8. Find its range. It is a different model. Here x plus 2y equal to 8 and 2y equal to 8 minus 6, y equal to 8 minus 6 by 2. Y is divisible by 2, it is very clear. Y is divisible by 2 and y is a natural number, means we can take even number only, so also not y is positive. Here x comma y belongs to capital N, that is capital N means natural numbers. What is natural number? Natural number 1, 2, 3, etc. 1, 2, 3, etc. And here we can take x equal to 2, 4, 6, 8. And when x equal to 2, y equal to 8 minus 2 by 2, that is 6 by 2, that is equal to 3. Continuing like this, we get y equal to 3, 2, 1, 0. It is range. Value of y is known as range and value of x is known as domain. Types of relation. In this section, we would like to study different types of relations. A relation is called an empty relation if no element of A is related to any element of A. Next one, what is a universal relation? Universal relation means each element of A is related to every element of A. Empty relation and universal relations are sometimes called trivial relations. For example, in a boys' school, no student of the school can be sister of any student of the school, therefore it is an empty relation. If the difference between heights of any student has to be less than 3 meters, it is a universal relation. Because in first case, it is an empty relation because there is no elements in first set. Next, reflexive relation. Reflexive relation means every element is related to every element in a set. For example, capital A. That is, a reflexive relation means, for example, multiple of 2 is a multiple of 2, 3 is a multiple of 3. Therefore, multiple of is a reflexive relation. Next one, symmetric relation. Symmetric relation means A related to B implies that B related to A. That means 2 is a reciprocal of 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is a reciprocal of 2, therefore it is symmetric. If A related to B, then B related to A, it is called a symmetric relation. Next one, transitive relation. Transitive relation means A related to B and B related to C implies that A related to C. That means 1 is related to 2 and 2 is related to 3, then 1 is related to 3, then it is called a transitive relation. For example, 2 less than 3, comma 3 less than 5, very clearly 2 less than 5, it is a transitive relation. Less than and smaller than are examples of transitive relation. Next question. If R is defined on (1, 2, 3) and R equal to 1, 2, 2, 1. It is a one mark question. Show that it is not transitive. Here 1 related to 1, 2 belongs to R and 2 related to 1, 2, 1 also belongs to R, but first element and last element, that is 1, 1, not in R, not belongs to R, therefore it is not transitive. A relation R in a set is said to be an equivalence relation if it is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. Next question. R equal to ordered pair XY. X comma Y belongs to N. 2x plus y equal to 24. Check whether it is an equivalence relation. What is an equivalence relation? Equivalence relation is, it must be reflexive, symmetric and transitive. Then it is called a equivalence relation. We want to check R is equivalence relation. That means it is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. 2x plus y equal to 24. Y equal to 24 minus 2x. Here note that y is positive. It is natural number. Since it is natural number, y is positive. So put x equal to 1, 2, 3, etc. 11. 1, 2, 3, etc. 11. We get y equal to 20, 22, 20, 18, etc. 2. Value of x is domain and value of y is range. First we want to check it is reflexive. Here x equal to 1, 2, 3, etc. 11. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, etc. are not in R. Therefore, it is not reflexive. Next, here x equal to 1, we get y equal to 24 minus 2 into 1. That is 24 minus 2. That is 22. That is 122 belongs to R. Put y equal to 22. X equal to 22.
x equal to 22, y equal to 24 minus 2 into 1. Here 1 belongs to 22. 1 comma 2, 22 belongs to R, but 22, 1 not belongs to R. Therefore, it is not symmetric. 122, 1 related to 22, but 22 not related to 1. It is not in R, therefore it is not symmetric. Next one, reflexivity. X equal to 7, y equal to 10. That is 7, 10 belongs to R. When x equal to 10, y equal to 4, that is 10, 4 also belongs to R. But first one and last one, that is 7, 4, not in R. Therefore, not transitive. Not transitive. Next one. Therefore, it is not reflexive, not transitive, and not symmetric, not reflexive, and not transitive. Therefore, it is not an equivalence relation. Next question. R defined on Z. Z means integer. R equal to ordered pair AB, A minus B is divisible by 5. Prove that R is a equivalence relation. R is a equivalence relation. Prove that R is an equivalence relation. First we want to check it is reflexive. XX belongs to R since x minus x equal to 0, 0 divisible by 5. Therefore, it is reflexive. Every element related to itself, so therefore it is reflexive. Next one, symmetric. X comma y belongs to R implies x minus y equal to divisible by 5, we can denote it 5k. Then y minus k equal to minus 5k. Yx belongs to R. Xy belongs to R implies yx belongs to R. Therefore, it is symmetric. Next, we want to check it is transitive. Xy belongs to R implies x minus y equal to 5k1. Yz belongs to R implies y minus z equal to 5k2. X minus y plus y minus z equal to 5k1 plus 5k2. Y and y get cancelled. X minus z equal to 5 into k1 plus k2. That is, x minus z is divisible by 5. X minus z divisible by 5. That is, x minus z divisible by 5 means xz belongs to xz belongs to R. Therefore, it is transitive. It is clearly reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. Therefore, it is a equivalence relation. Next one. R is defined on real numbers. R is defined on real numbers. R equal to A comma B, such that A comma B belongs to real numbers. Real numbers. A less than or equal to B cube. Is we want here prove that R is neither reflexive nor symmetric nor transitive. R is neither symmetric nor transitive nor reflexive. ഒരു കേസിലും പെടുന്നില്ല. Reflexive അല്ല, transitive അല്ല, symmetric അല്ല. Next one. First we check it is reflexive. Put A equal to half. Half less than or equal to half cube. Not possible. Therefore, half comma half not belongs to R. Therefore, not reflexive. Next one. A equal to minus 2. B equal to 3. A comma B belongs to R implies minus 2 less than 3 cube. B comma A belongs to R implies 3 less than or equal to minus 2 cube. It is not possible. Therefore, must imply 3 less than or equal to minus 2 cube. It is not possible. Therefore, it is not symmetric. Here, A comma B belongs to R, but B comma A not belongs to R. Therefore, it is not symmetric. Next one. A equal to 3, B equal to 3 by 2, C equal to 4 by 3. A comma B belongs to R implies 3 less than or equal to 3 by 2 cube. B comma C belongs to R implies 3 by 2 less than or equal to 4 by 3 cube. But A comma C not in R since 3 less than or equal to 4 by 3 cube not possible. Therefore, not transitive. Therefore, it is not an equivalence relation. Next question. R defined on or R defined on R defined on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. R equal to ordered pair AB such that modulus of A minus B is even. Modulus of A minus B is even. Prove that it is an equivalence relation. Prove that R is an equivalence relation. Equivalence relation. Equivalence relation means we want to prove it is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. First one, we want to check it is reflexive. X comma X belongs to R since modulus of X minus X equal to 0, it is a even number. Therefore, X comma X belongs to R for every X, so it is reflexive. So it is reflexive. Next we want to check it is symmetric. X comma Y belongs to R implies X minus Y even. Implies Y minus X also even. Implies YX belongs to R. Therefore it is symmetric. It is symmetric. Next one. Transitivity. X comma Y belongs to R, implies x minus y even. Y z belongs to R, implies y minus z even. And what is next? Clearly, x minus y even, y minus z even means x, y and y, z are both odd or both even. Therefore, x minus z is clearly even. Therefore, x comma z belongs to R. So, it is transitive. Therefore, this relation is a equivalence relation. Function. Let x and y be two non-empty set. A function f from x to y is a rule by which each element is associated to a unique element. Example for function is mother of. Every children have only mother. Therefore, it is a function. Not more than one mother. Therefore, it is a function. Next, domain and range of a function. What is domain and range of a function? The element of x. If f is a function from x to y, then x is called a domain and y is called a codomain. And image of the set is called range. F is from x to y, x is called a domain, y is called a codomain, and set of images is called range. A function is said to be one-one or injective function if distinct element have distinct images. Then it is called a one-one function or injective function. F of x equal to f of y implies x equal to y. Means if images are equal, then elements are equal. Otherwise, f is called a many-one function. A function is said to be onto function if every element is the image of some element of x under f. That is, in second set, every element must possess three images. Also, a function is said to be onto function if codomain equal to range. Next one, bijective function. A function is said to be bijective if it is one-one and onto. We can discuss first one-one function. One-one function means every different elements possess different images. For example, students air their seats in an exam hall. Students and their seats in a tour bus is a many-one function. There is a chance for every student can occupy one seat. Example for a one-one function, 1, 2, A, B, Z, 2 related to Z and 1 related to B, it is 1-1. And another examples, 1, 2, 3 are related to A, therefore it is not 1-1. 1-1 function means every element must possess different images. Onto function. Onto function means range equal to codomain. Every element must possess three images. Here 1, 2, 3, A, B, C, D. It is 1-1 and onto. Every element in second set must possess three images and it is also bijective, since bijective means 1-1 and onto. Problem. A equal to 1, 2, 3. B equal to 4, 5, 6, 7. F equal to 1, 4, 2, 5, 3, 6. Check whether F is 1, 1 or not. Check whether F is 1, 1 or not. Here we can draw a Venn diagram. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1 related to 4, 2 related to 5, 3 related to 6. It is clearly 1, 1. F of 1 equal to 4, F of 2 equal to 5, F of 3 equal to 6. Distinct element have distinct images, therefore it is 1, 1. Here, range equal to 2, 4, 4, 5, 6, not equal to codomain. Codomain equal to B. Range not equal to codomain, therefore it is not onto. It is not onto. It is 1, 1 function, but not onto function. Next question. F from R to R. F from R to R. F of x equal to ax plus b. Show that it is bijective function. It is bijective function. To check it is bijective, we must check it is 1, 1. That is f of x1 equal to f of x2. Implies x1 equal to x2. F of x1 equal to f of x2 implies ax1 plus b equal to ax2 plus b. B and b get cancelled. Ax1 equal to ax2. A and a must cancelled. X1 equal to x2. Therefore, it is 1, 1. Every linear functions are 1, 1 functions. 1, 1 functions. Next, we want to check it is onto. Y equal to ax plus b. Ax equal to y minus b. X equal to y minus b divided by a. For each, y belongs to R. Here, f from R to R. R domain and R also codomain. For each y belongs to R, there exists x equal to y minus b divided by a belongs to R such that f of x equal to f of y minus b divided by a equal to put f of x equal to ax plus b, therefore we put y minus b divided by a in the place of x in the function f of x, that is a into y minus b divided by a plus b. A and a get cancelled, y minus b plus b equal to y. Clearly it is onto, therefore it is onto, therefore it is bijective. It is bijective. Next question. A from n to n. N means natural numbers. Natural numbers means 1, 2, 3, etc. Natural numbers 1, 2, 3, etc. F of x equal to n plus 1 by 2 if n is odd. Odd natural number and n by 2 n even natural number. Find whether f is bijective. find whether F is bijective. F is bijective. Here, first we check it is 1, 1. Next on 2. F of n equal to n plus 1 by 2 n odd. We put n equal to 1. F of 1 equal to 1 plus 1 by 2, that is 2 by 2, that is equal to 1. Next, f of n equal to n by 2, n even. Put n equal to 2, f of 2 equal to 2 by 2, that's equal to 1. Here, f of 1 equal to f of 2, but 1 not equal to 2. Therefore, it is not 1, 1. Therefore, it is not bijective. It is not bijective. If 2n minus 1 is the general form of odd natural numbers, 2n minus 1 is the general form of odd natural numbers. F of 2n minus 1 equal to f of 2n minus 1 equal to 2n minus 1 plus 1 by 2, that's equal to n. If 2n is the general form of an even natural number, f of 2n equal to 2n by 2, that is also n. For every number, there exists pre-image in n. For every number, there exists pre-image in n. Next question. We can discuss f of x equal to x divided by x plus 2. Check whether f is 1-1 function. F is 1-1 function. F of x1 equal to f of x2. X1 by x1 plus 2 equal to x2 by x2 plus 2. Cross multiply x1 into x2 plus 2 equal to x2 into x1 plus 2. That is x1 x2 plus 2 x1 equal to x2 x1 plus 2 x2. X2 x1 x2 x1 get cancelled. 2 x1 equal to 2 x2 implies x1 equal to x2. It is clearly 1 1. For checking 1 1 function, we want to check f of x1 equal to f of x2. Implies x1 equal to x2.
Logic, School of Management. It is simple logic.